Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I need you to talk to me. Let me know when it's on, please, sir. She said. Thank you. All right. We thank God again for another day. We honor him for his many, many, many blessings. Thank God he allowed us to get up this morning and come to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. We thank those that are here to join us this morning at the Master's Touch Worship Center. And we praise God for your presence. And we also thank those that may be joining us online as well. We will start with this morning's selection. This is not our music. This is not our music.
You restore my soul.
All right.
When you become a believer.
Thank you, Father. This is not our music.
Sometimes the soul doesn't get the notice. It has a hole in it due to things that's happened in the past. Hurt, abuse, molestation. But we want to speak to you today and tell you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. Some people's actions are not because their spirit is wrong, but it's because the past has left a hole in their soul. May this wisdom help you get over your past and remind you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. I have my sister Leandria here. She's going to help me share this wisdom and tell this story. Control your future. Starting now, this is a new day. This is
did you mess me up like that? Good God Almighty. Woo! Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. You know, if you be true to thyself, that is everybody's testimony. Lord, deliver me from me. Good God Almighty. I've been listening to that song. I know my wife thinks I'm crazy. Every day, all day, just about for the last 2 weeks. My God, my God, my God. Baby, thank you for that. And truth be told, we were running around this morning trying to figure out what song, what song, what song. And just as God always does, he just has a way of showing up and showing out. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank God for his presence this morning. Oh, we thank God, Lord, for your love, for your grace, and for your peace. And let me tell you, God is just such an awesome, awesome, wonderful God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So this morning, we are going to continue in the service. We're going to have Lady Monica come and do her part in reading scripture, prayer, announcements. And of course, what would a Sunday be without the Lady Monica-ism? Hallelujah, hallelujah. So we're going to have Lady Monica to come this morning and do her thing as she always does so eloquently. That's all right. That's all right.
Yeah.
That's all right.
Yeah.
All right. I need to talk a little bit. Glory God. Well, so Lady Monica won't have to do the announcements. I'll go ahead and do the announcements. So again, this Thursday, we will be having our couples retreat. And we would ask that you guys would come and join us. This Thursday at 7 p.m., 3331 Blue Ridge Road. We are excited about what God is doing in these couples retreats. We've gotten so much feedback, and just God is just doing such a mighty, mighty, mighty work. So if you've never experienced a couples retreat, we ask that you would come and join us again this Thursday, 7 p.m., 3331 Blue Ridge Road. And as usual, if there's any service that you have ever missed and you want to see and experience, you can do that one of two ways. You can go to our YouTube page and just search TMTWC. Where all of the services are there. And then you could also go to our Facebook page and like us on Facebook. You can go to Facebook and search the same thing, TMTWC, and you can see most of our services there as well. And then also you can follow us on Twitter at TMTWC1. And then Instagram, TMTWC9, 9 representing the month the church was birthed. And then our website, yep, you guessed it, TMTWC.org. And from the website, you can actually access everything from the website. So we thank God for this morning announcements, and we're gonna have Lady Monica come now, but don't worry about the music. We don't have to have it. We'll be all right. We're gonna have Lady Monica come and read scripture, pray, and her Monica is, she's wearing one of my favorite dresses this morning.
Praise God. Praise God. Let's give the Lord a hand clap. If everyone would do that, you know, do it like he is standing in front of you, blessing you right now, because he is. Praise him like you do when you get your check on Friday or Tuesday or Thursday, whatever day. Praise him when something good has happened in your life. Praise him just because you woke up this morning.
Amen.
You know, with every breath, praise him because he is worthy to be praised. And let me tell you, if you don't have anything, any reason to praise him, you are dead. Okay? Because we all have something to praise him for.
Amen. I know that's right.
So, you know, just remember that when you're struggling, when you're seeing the things that's going on in your life, when it seems like it's trial after trial after trial, door closed after door closed after door closed.
My God.
You know, financial issues, your children won't do right, your spouse won't do right, on the job it's just wearing you down. But remember, remember, we have something to shout about.
I know
that's
right, girl.
We have something to praise about.
Say
that. We have something to go forward with because God, he shed his only son. He gave his only son. He shed it, the blood for you and I, so we can be right here, right now.
My God.
So you should never sit
Hallelujah.
And look like you lost. You should
Hallelujah.
Never sit like you ain't
Glory
got nothing.
God.
You should never sit like, you know what? I just, you know, life ain't happening for me. You should never sit around feeling like that because if he's done nothing else for you.
Say it, girl. Say it. Good God Almighty.
He died for you. Let me tell you, he died for you.
Jesus,
and I thank
Jesus,
him.
Jesus.
I thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Okay, we're going to, if you guys will get your Bibles, we're going to read from Ecclesiastes chapter 7, starting at verse 15. In my life, in my fruitful life, I've seen everything, someone righteous perish in the spirit of his righteousness, and someone wicked lives long in spirit of his evil. Don't be excessively righteous, and don't be overly wise.
All right.
Why should you destroy yourself? Don't be excessively wicked, and don't be foolish. Why should you die before your time?
My God.
It is good that you grasp the one who do and not let the other slip from your hand. For the one who fears God will end up with both of them.
Woo,
I read
Jesus.
To you Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verses 15, 16, 17, and 18.
All right.
And may God bless the hearers and the readers of his read word.
Amen.
And the doers.
I receive it.
Okay, so I do not have to read the announcements. I just want to remind you that we will not be here on the first Thursday of August and the first Sunday of August. So we will be traveling to Ohio to share with the union of our brother Vincent Slaughter and Tracy. We are so excited, and we'll be spending some time with family. It's been long overdue, so we're looking forward to that. So that govern yourselves accordingly to that. If you can always go back and look at our past services and our, you know, on YouTube and Facebook. Pastor Slaughter had mentioned about our YouTube and our Facebook page, so you can go back there and review those services. Pastor Slaughter is hurrying me up, y'all. I tell you. Okay, so I'm going to read my Monica-ism for today.
All right.
Character is both developed and revealed by tests, and all it is tests. You're always being tested. God constantly watches your response to people, problems, success, conflict, illnesses, disappointments, and even the weather.
My God.
In my own life, I've noticed that God has tested my faith through my problems and how I handle my possessions and tests for my love through people. So remember, character is both developed and revealed by tests. So you know, you can't know what kind of person you are. You haven't been tested. You know, if you haven't been tested with a loss of a loved one, if you haven't been tested when God has blessed you, giving you possessions and giving you desires of your heart, He is testing you to see if you are going to allow that to be your God. So remember, you know, your character is built on things that God bless you with and how you can be a blessing to others, because it tells a lot about who you are on how you love, on how you covered the things that God bless in your life. So remember, character is both developed and revealed by tests.
My God.
Okay? Wow. Now, if you all would get your offering in hand, God wants you to get, be a part of this worship by getting your offering in your hand. If you don't have a paper offering, we will take the card because we have swipe. So we're asking everyone to be obedient to God's word. And if everyone could stand, and if you're on my left, go left. If you're on my right, go right. And if you're on the internet, our internet family, our Facebook family, thank you so much for supporting us. We need your support as well.
Amen.
So if you could go on to Tithely or Giveify or even the website or Cash App us at TMTWC. We will take whatever God has laid on your heart to give. And this is really great ground to sow a seed.
Amen.
You know, we are doing some great things here, and we want to continue to do God's will and His way.
Amen.
And we want to continue to do His work. And we have to do it with gifts, with money, you know, everything. You know, 99 problems of your problems can be solved with money. Just remember that. So we do need your money to be able to build this kingdom, continue building this kingdom. And we appreciate you being obedient. And if you all could stand so we can pray of the offering, please. Excuse me. Can you guys stand? Thank you. Yeah. Father God, we come to you, God, just thanking you, God. Thanking you, Father, for those that gave and those that had the desire but did not have the means. Thank you, God, for our internet family, the ones that, you know, sowed a seed virtual. We appreciate that. We thank God for them. And we pray that, God, that we use this money to be uplifted for your kingdom, God. And we use these offerings that we can build your kingdom. And we just thank you for who you are. And we ask this all in your name, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
All right. So Pastor Slider is like raring to get up here, guys. So I am going to turn this mic over. He can have it. And did you remind them about the fruit?
No.
I just want to remind you guys, we had Bible study, which was great. If you missed it, go back and look at it. He talked about patience. Such a great fruit. Such a great fruit. Something that we all think we have, but we don't really have patience because we don't want to wait. We don't want to wait. We are in traffic honking. We will text someone, and if they don't reply, we're calling. When we are in line, we're like looking to see what's going on ahead of us. But God wants us to slow down and have patience. So the past series, He's talked about love. He talked about joy. He's talked about peace. And last Thursday, He talked about patience. And the second Thursday of August, He'll be talking about gentleness, and that's another great fruit. So if you missed it, please refer back to YouTube or Facebook, and I thank you guys for being obedient to God's word. I think next time we're going to have the boys open up for us. Yeah. Okay.
Thanks. So, amen. Amen. I just want to reiterate, on giving, we need your offering. This ministry, God's hand is on it, and we pray that His hand be on your heart to give and to help us as we walk in what God has preordained. Again, you can go to our website, which is the easiest way, tmtwc.org. All you have to do is click on give, and every way to give is right there. Tithely, Giveify, Cash App, and even our address if you'd like to mail something in. So we thank God for his moment, his presence. And Lady Monica mentioned I was so anxious to get up here. That's because this word has been in me for the last 2 weeks, and we're going to jump right in to the word. Babe, you want to hit that? It's out, baby. It's out. It's out. Father, in the name of Jesus, I command this that is in here to be removed. I command your Holy Spirit to cover in the name of Jesus. It's nothing but the enemy, because he knows this word that's about to come forth. Open the doors. You guys, there's a couple of wasps in here, and my wife is allergic to the sting. So we are going to, man, don't hit. Just open the door. Hold on, just take this. Let's just go out with it. We're just going to take it out with it. Don't hit it. We're just going to let it. Open the door for me, Emmanuel. Yeah, we're just going to take it out. Let it go. There we go. All right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank God. We're not going to allow God to interrupt this word that's going forth. Thank you, Jesus. My wife is petrified. Because if she gets stung, we have to rush her to the hospital. And she does not play with that. So we thank God that these beautiful flowers are here that attract that wasp and allow me to just to carry it right out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So, Father, we thank you, God, for your presence this morning. We honor you for who you are and what you represent in our lives. Lord, we ask that you would speak this morning, God, and allow your words to go forth, Lord, the way you gave me this word. Father, you told me when you called me to preach, if I just stand up here, hallelujah, that you would speak through me. Well, Father, I'm reminding you this morning of your words. I ask that you would speak this morning. And flow, Father, the way you gave it to me. Lord, I ask that you would prepare every heart, mind, and soul for this word this morning. Set the atmosphere, Father, to make preaching easy, that your words may go forth. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. And everybody said, amen. Amen, amen, amen. You know, the enemy knows when a blessing is coming. Whenever a real, genuine blessing is coming, the enemy has a way of trying to divert you and get you all worked up so you can tend to abort that blessing and focus on what the enemy is trying to show you. But thank God that there is nowhere in the Word of God that says we need to look at the situation or circumstance. Thank God that His Bible says that we walk by faith. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And not by sight. Not by sight. So this morning, beloved, I would ask that you be patient with me, and I don't know how God is going to do or what he's going to do, but this morning, I just want to use as a thought this morning, fighting you that God may get the glory. Fighting you that God may get the glory. And
I just ask, if the truth be told, I didn't already preached just in that thought. Just think about that. What that means. What is that saying to you? Fighting you that God may get the glory. You know, God, I forget what happened or what was going on, but God planted that in my spirit weeks ago. And since he planted it, I've tried to preach it, and I've tried to preach it, and he wouldn't give me no more to it. Until yesterday, my oldest son came to me, and he came to me and asked me about, you know, he was playing basketball, and some guy was talking a lot of stuff, and he was saying, you know, Dad, you know, it just bothers me so much. And he just kept talking, and, you know, he talked about going to get some guns, or, and I riled up, and, you know, he was, and he asked me, how do you deal with that? How do you handle that? And God reminded me in that moment of the word that he gave me about fighting yourself that God may get the glory. So I spoke with him, and I talked to him about that. And we were able to discuss things, and soon after that happened, it's like God just started downloading and downloading things into me. So this morning, we're going to talk about fighting you that God may get the glory. And we're just going to give some examples of what that means. We're going to talk about what it looks like. And then we want to talk about why you want to do that. So my reference text that I want to go to is John 14 and 13. And it says, "And I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father," good God Almighty, "may be glorified in the Son." Hallelujah. "And I will do whatever you ask in my name." Not that I can get the glory. Not that my name can be lifted up. Not that you can look at me and say I did it. Good God Almighty. But the Bible says, so that the Father may get the glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So, beloved, we have to understand that as we walk in this life, the world wants everything to be about you and what you can do. The world promotes, go get yours. The world promotes is, you know, you be first. The world promotes that you can't worry about everybody else. You gotta do you. Hallelujah. And anyone that has been a part of this ministry for any period of time, you know that one of the main things that we talk about is what this world says is in total contradiction of what the word of God says. And beloved, I'm afraid this morning that there are a whole lot of us who are accused and have been confined to know that you are stealing God's glory. And he's bothered by it. He's upset by it. He's not feeling your love. Why? Because you want it to be all about you. And beloved, it's so easy to get caught up in that because of what this world says and what this world promotes. And beloved, if we go to the text, if we could go to Romans 7, we're going to read verses 23 through the end of Romans. Romans 7, 23. And we're going to read through the end of 25. And then we're going to end at Romans 8 and 1. And for those of you who don't know, you know, the Bible was originally written not in chapter and verse. Chapters and verse was done later on to help us be able to understand it more and to learn the scripture. But when you read the book of Romans, it was just one letter to the Romans. It wasn't divided by chapter and verse. So when you read, as we're reading Romans 7:23, and we're going to 8:1, it is a total flow. Man put the chapters and the verses in the text. So as we read this, and we're talking about fighting you, that God may get the glory. So Romans 7:23 says, "Ooh, Jesus." He says, "But I see another law in my members, warring against the law of my mind and bringing me into captivity to the law of sin, which is in my members. Oh, wretched man that I am, who will deliver me," good God, "from this body of death? I thank God through Jesus Christ our Lord." Hallelujah. "So then, with the mind, I myself serve the law of God, but with the flesh, the law of sin." That 8th chapter and 1st verse continues. And he says, "There is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus." So, beloved, we see here that in the 7th chapter of Romans, Paul does an excellent example of the battle between the flesh and your spirit. He talks about how what I want to do that I don't do, and then that I don't want to do, good God Almighty, I find myself doing. And here he talks about another law that is warring against the law of his mind. So, beloved, we see here Paul is letting you know that you are in constant battle to fight the law of your mind in this world. And then he asks the question. He says, "Who will deliver me from this body of death?" And there's no one who would deliver him but Jesus Christ. And then in that first verse of that 8th chapter, he lets you know that there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. See, a lot of us think that that's where the verse ends. A lot of us think that when we say there is therefore no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, that that's it. That I can just sin and there is no condemnation because I'm in Christ Jesus. But see, that ain't where it ends. The next part of that verse says, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. See, you have a continuation there. It's easy to just preach and talk about there is no condemnation to those that are in Christ. Basically, what they're trying to make you think is, if I just go to church, if I'm just around the gospel, if I just talk the talk, then there is no condemnation. But that's not where the story ends. The story continues and says, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. So, beloved, we find here in the text that this is the first example of fighting you that God may get the glory. See, you within yourself, you're going to please you. You want to do what this flesh wants to do. I remember when I was talking to my son and God brought back to my remembrance just how this thought manifested in my life. I was at work and my manager, he's a new manager, and he's a young guy, and you know, he's ambitious and you know, wants to do what's right and what's good, and you know, and he exerts himself, and you know, he's the type of individual, you know, when our first meeting, he said that, you know, I'm the kind of person that I'm just gonna tell you what's on my mind. I'm just like that. I'm just gonna give it to you and I'm gonna give it to you raw. And I said, well, brother, I'm the kind of man, I got thick skin. And if you give it to me raw, I can take it. But don't be surprised if you give it raw, you don't get it back raw. So what happened, I was talking to my son, I was telling him, my manager came over to me, and we were discussing one of the doctors. And the day before, he had told me to speak with one of the other representatives about this doctor. Well, I got caught up doing some other things, and I was going to speak with her that day. Well, the doctor replied to one of our web advertisements about this job that he wanted. So my manager came over to me, and he came over very strong and, you know, John, didn't I tell you to speak with what's your name? What happened? And just in my face and going, and as he was talking, God reminded me, fight you, good God Almighty, that I may get the glory. So immediately as he started, I felt my flesh, good God Almighty, rising up in me, because I wanted to let him know, your children are at home. you talking to a grown man, but God and his presence reminded me of what he told me. He reminded me, he said, fight you that I may get the glory. So as my boss was talking, I had to pray. I said, God, I need your fruit to manifest right now. I need you to settle me, because you know me. You know what I want to tell this man. You know what I want to let him know. And beloved, let me tell you, it would have felt so good, good God Almighty, to let that man know what I wanted to know. But see, if I would have done that, who would have gotten the glory? Me. My flesh. And I would have felt good, and I would have walked around like, yeah, I let him know who I am. But that ain't giving God glory. So I let him talk and I let him go, and I was just like, yep, okay, I got it right. And then a few minutes later, the person who he told me to speak to got on him because one of his doctors doesn't want to work with him anymore because of the way he talks to her.
Wow.
Just that fast, God showed up. And then he let me know how to go to him and speak to him that can bless him and in return bless me. And who gets the glory? God gets the glory. Because now I can minister to him and let him know and show him how he came to me. Show him how he's losing this doctor because of how he's doing things. And who gets the glory in that? God gets the glory. We have another example. That's just me. We can go to the Word of God. If we go to Joseph, Joseph, speak to us of how fighting you, good God, allows God to get the glory. If we go to Genesis 40 and 8, it says, "We both had dreams," they answered, "but there is no one to interpret them." Then Joseph said, "Do not interpretations, good God Almighty, belong to God? Tell me your dreams." See, Joseph had a gift of interpreting dreams. Hallelujah. But Joseph never forgot who gave him the gift. Joseph always wanted to make sure that God got the glory. Hallelujah. For the gift that he has. And beloved, that's a lesson. That's a lesson for a lot of us. You know, God has blessed a lot of us to do a lot of things, to do certain jobs, to sing, to preach, to play basketball, to be able to talk, to be able to do business, to be able to do deals. And a lot of us get so caught up in the us, good God Almighty, that we forget about the one that blessed us with the ability to do what we're doing. And if we go to, we scoot down to Genesis 41, 15 and 16, it says, Pharaoh said to Joseph, "I had a dream, and no one can interpret it, but I have heard it said of you that when you hear a dream, you can interpret it." Now, a lot of us at that point would have been like, yeah, just let me know your dream. I got it, because I want to be the man. I want to be the one that gets the glory. But that ain't what Joseph said. Joseph says, "I cannot do it." Good God Almighty. Joseph replied. He said, "But God, good God, will give Pharaoh the answer," hallelujah, "that he desires." Why did Joseph, no matter what the situation, no matter what the circumstance, why did he choose to give God the glory? Why would Joseph take that moment and not say, "Yes, I can do it. So you can give me the promotion"? Because Joseph didn't want to put anything in anybody else's hand. He wanted to keep it in God's hands. Hallelujah. It would have been easy for Joseph to say, "Yes, I'm an interpreter. I can interpret dreams. I'm the man. I can do the sale. Call on me. I can make the shot. Throw it to me in the last seconds when it's tied up. I can do it. But Joseph wanted to give glory to God, hallelujah, so that God can continue to keep his hands on him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we've looked at me, and I've given you an example in my life of how fighting you that God may get the glory. And we've looked at Joseph, and we know Joseph in Rideau. See, Joseph went through time after time after time to where he just got put down, where you would think God had forgot about him. But even in those times, Joseph still gave God the glory. And what happened to Joseph? He ended up being second in command, hallelujah, under the Pharaoh. Why? Because he chose to fight him. Good God Almighty. He chose to fight himself from getting the glory, that God may get the glory. So basically what he was saying is, God, I trust you more with my life than I trust myself in doing it in me. Glory God. Hallelujah. And beloved, we have another example of fighting you that God may get the glory. If we go to Daniel 3, verses 16 through 18, it says, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. If that is the case, our good God Almighty, our God, whom we served, is able, good God Almighty, to deliver us from this burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us from your hand, O King. Hallelujah. And then that 18th verse says, but if not, good God Almighty, let it be known to you, O King, that we do not serve your gods, nor will we worship the gold image which you have set up. Hallelujah. See, beloved, there's going to be times in your life that you can have increase, and you can get riches, and you can make the moves, and you can do all these things if you bow down, hallelujah, to what this world wants. But God, you got to fight. You got to fight that thing that's rising up in you, that God may get the glory. See, Nebuchadnezzar wanted everybody to bow down, and they had just given Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego a raise, and there was managers where they were. And they said, when the music plays, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, you got to bow down, hallelujah, to this God and this golden image. But he said, no, they say you gave me the raise and you give me this money, but I cannot give glory to your God. I must fight. This is what's in me. Because, beloved, you know that they had to be thinking, well, look what he done for us. This is where we work. This is what we're doing. And look, everybody else, hallelujah, is bowing down. Everybody else is giving over to what the king does. We can just do it this one time. We can just settle this one time. But they decided, good God Almighty, to fight themselves, that God would get the glory. Hallelujah. And if we scoot down to that third chapter, verses 24 and 25, it says, then King Nebuchadnezzar was astonished, and he rose in haste and spoke, saying to his counselors, did we not cast three men bound into the midst of the fire? And they answered and said to the king, true, O king. And then that 25th verse says, look, he answered, I see four men loose, hallelujah, walking in the midst of the fire, and they are not hurt. And the fourth of them, hallelujah, is like the Son of God. Good God Almighty. See, beloved, when you deny you, what you're doing is saying, God, I give you glory. I'm giving you the authority to step in this situation and handle it, hallelujah, the way you see fit. Glory, God. See, beloved, a lot of you know the story, but when they was about to put Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the furnace, the king said, turn the furnace up seven times of what it is right now. They turned it up so high that the men that turned it up got burnt up by turning it up. And then as they went into the fire, beloved, and beloved, that, and see, that's when you go through life and you are in the fire. You see these bills. You see that you didn't take that job because you knew God didn't tell you to take the job. And now you didn't took this other job and you ain't making as much money. But you're looking over here and saying, oh, God, why didn't you give me that? Why didn't you allow that to happen? And you can get even a word from the doctor that says you got this disease. You got that long to live. You got this going on. But, beloved, let me tell you, fight, hallelujah. Fight you, hallelujah, that God may get the glory. And then the God of this earth will come down and suffer and abide with you. The God of this earth will raise up, hallelujah, and allow you to walk in the furnace and not even be burned. Hallelujah. King Nebuchadnezzar looked in there and he said, didn't we put three in there tied up? And now I look, four is in there and they're all loosed and free. Beloved, let me tell you, there is no other person that I would rather have in my life to control and to be over what is I'm going through in my life than God. Yes. Hallelujah. But beloved, it's so easy to get caught up in you. It's so easy to do what you want and be caught up in your will and all about you and your house and your car and your money. Hallelujah. Matter of fact, this morning, my baby didn't even know what I was going to preach about. And we started talking about how a lot of these singers, when they first start singing, they're at the throne and you can feel their presence and they're just giving glory to God. But it's like as their career takes them higher and higher, it's less about God and more about this world. Why does that happen? Why? Because they've decided to serve the things of this world than the word of God. They've decided to trust themselves. Hallelujah. Opposed to giving glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And my last example, hallelujah, is Jesus Christ. Good God Almighty. Yeah. The Son of God. God manifested in flesh. Beloved, have you ever wondered why Jesus, the Messiah, Jesus, God in flesh, why Jesus never did anything in his own name? Why Jesus didn't even take the glory, good God Almighty, in himself? Hallelujah. I know you're looking at me strange. You're looking at me crazy. John 12:49 says, for I have not spoken on my own authority, but the Father who has sent me gave me a command what I should say and what I should speak. Good God Almighty. John 7:16 said, Jesus answered them and said, my doctrine is not mine, but his, good God Almighty, who sent me. Even Jesus is letting them know that it's not about me.
Yes.
It's not about my wants and my needs. Why? Because Jesus had on a fresh uniform, y'all. Y'all don't understand this. Jesus had on the flesh uniform, and he knew he could not trust himself in the flesh uniform that he had on. Hallelujah. John 14 and 10 says, do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own authority, but the Father who dwells in me does the work. And beloved, that same God, that same Spirit that dwells in Jesus, guess what? Dwells in your mortal bodies. Hallelujah. Beloved, we have a choice to fight us or give God the glory. And my last example in Jesus is John 8, 28 and 29. And it says, then Jesus said to them, when you lift up the Son of Man, then you will know that I am he, and that I do nothing of myself, good God Almighty, but as my Father, hallelujah, has taught me, I speak these things. And he who sent me is with me. The Father has not left me alone, for I always do the things that please him. Hallelujah. So, beloved, if it's good enough for Jesus, hallelujah, to fight himself and give God the glory, hallelujah, then, beloved, it's good enough for me. Hallelujah. And I know you're thinking, well, beloved, I know you're thinking, well, Pastor, if you're saying all these things, and I hear what you're saying, why, good God Almighty, why do I need to fight myself? Why do I need to give God the glory? Well, beloved, we can look at Jesus' life. We can look at Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. We can look at Joseph's life. All of these examples, when they gave it to God, basically what they were saying is, God, I choose not to handle this, because I know whoever gets the glory makes the rules. Hallelujah. And I don't have the strength within myself to be able to take this and do this. So I'm giving you the glory, good God Almighty, that you can have the say so. I want to put it in your hands, because where I've been, I've messed up. I am where I am in my life because of decisions, good God Almighty, that I'm making. But beloved, as I come to a close, I believe Paul, hallelujah, sums it up to where we all can receive it and walk out of here knowing why we need to fight ourselves that God may get the glory. Romans 8, hallelujah, 37 through 39, Paul sums it up. He says, yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors, not in ourselves. We are more than conquerors through him, good God Almighty, who loved us. Paul says, for I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, hallelujah, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able, hallelujah, to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. So Paul is letting you know that God loves you. that God wants to be a part of your life and God wants the glory. And no matter what you've done, no matter how you've done it, no matter where you've been, no matter what you've been through, nothing, hallelujah, will separate you from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. So, beloved, through your life, through your trials, through your testimonies, fight you, hallelujah, that God, good God Almighty, that God can get the glory. You want God to be the outcome in your life. You can't handle the outcome, because if you could, you wouldn't be, hallelujah, in the position that you're in. But God, but beloved, let me tell you, don't be fooled. Don't be fooled and think just because you're going through that God ain't with you. Hallelujah. Sometime God got to take you through, good God Almighty, to position you in a place that you can receive, good God Almighty, the glory, hallelujah, that he has for you. So, beloved, hallelujah, if you get nothing from this message, please know this. Continue to fight you. You don't need the glory. You can't handle the glory. Fight you, hallelujah, hallelujah. That God, God Almighty, that God may get the glory. And when God gets the glory, he will tell your story. When God, hallelujah, 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 hey God, when God gets the glory, he starts to write your story. He starts to write your end. You may not see it because he didn't tell you to walk by sight, but you give God the glory, hallelujah, and you will end up like Joseph, second in command, hallelujah. You will end up like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, walking in the fire, was bound, but now you loose. But they had to go through, hallelujah. They had to look at the fire. They had to see all the people bowing down. They had to go through. But because they gave God the glory, they knew God was penning their story. And even Jesus, hallelujah, when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane, his flesh was crying out, no, 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 no. We can't go through this cross. We can't go through this pain. But Jesus said, not my will, hallelujah, but thy will be done. And they thought they had him. They thought when they took him down from the cross and buried him in the tomb that they had him. But y'all don't know, God was still writing, because Jesus gave God the glory and he was still writing. And my Bible tells me that he got up. Good God Almighty. He got up with all, hallelujah, all power. Not some, not a little bit. Beloved, if you want all power in your hand, you got to give God, hallelujah, hallelujah, the glory. Good God Almighty, hallelujah, if we could all stand. Glory, God. Glory, God. Lord, thank you for your word. If we could all stand, this is not our music. This is not our music. It's God's music. Oh, Jesus, God's music. If we could all stand, hallelujah. If there be one. Woo, Jesus. If there be one that says, Pastor, I'm tired of taking the glory. I'm tired of being unfulfilled with all my riches, with my cars and in my position. I'm tired of living life as a fake. And I'm ready to give God, good God Almighty. Thank you, Lord. Woo! I'm ready to give God the glory in my life. It's time out.
I want to
for playing church.
The secret.
It's time out for you having the glory. You can't write the story the way God can. Allow God to have control to write the ending to your story. Where you're in Christ and you've trusted Him, but you've fallen to the wayside. You've taken the blessings of God and taken them on yourself. You've taken God's grace and counted it as your own. And you see that there's nothing, no more meaning in life for you. Because you're just going through the motions. Would you come? Would you come and rededicate your life back to Jesus? For Paul said that nothing will separate you. Not even you can separate you from the love of Jesus Christ. His arms are still open for you. To come back to Jesus. And if there be one where you say, Pastor, I see what you and Lady Monica are doing. I want to be a part of the Master's Touch Worship Center. Would you come? Father, we thank you, Lord. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your power. Thank you for continuing to be God in our lives. Father, I ask in the name of Jesus that you would touch every living soul in this place. That you would cover us in the blood of Jesus. And that you would help us to fight us that you may get the glory. And Father, if there be anyone online, even right now, that chooses to make a decision for you, God, meet them right now where they are. Lift them up in you, God, that you may be glorified in the name of Jesus. Lord, we love you, we thank you, and we honor your holy, precious name. For it is in the name of Jesus Christ that we pray. And we all said amen, amen, amen. And let me say this, beloved. There is a remnant that watches the Master's Touch Worship Center every Sunday. You're sitting at home and you're praising God. God, let me tell you right now, we need you here. We need you. Yep, I'm talking to you. Lord, put this on my heart this morning. We need you to come down. I know you've gone through church hurt. I know you have in your mind everything that says why not to come. I want to see you Thursday. I want to see you Thursday, and I know that God is even speaking to your heart right now. And he's allowing the man of God to call you out. It's time out for making excuses. And it's time to give your life totally to Jesus. Because God has blessed you with gifts that the body needs. And we want to see you. I want you to come and tell me, Pastor, yep, you was talking to me. So I can embrace you and hug you and love on you. Hallelujah. Anything else, baby? Good God Almighty. Woo! Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Father. I want to make sure to hug and shake everybody's hands in this place. Father, we thank you for once again being God in our lives. We thank you, God, for showing up and having your way. We thank you, God, for allowing your glory to manifest itself today in the Master's Touch Worship Center. We shall continue to give you all the glory and all the honor. Father, touch these, your people. Cover us, Father, in the blood of Jesus. Protect us from this world and protect us from ourselves. For God, we love you and we thank you. It is in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, that we pray. And everybody said, amen, amen.
Show me your face.